How you guys doing today? It's Coach D, and welcome to Unit 2. We're going to talk today a little bit about getting into the core things of being a better teammate. We talked last unit about having better character, basically through your attitude, your effort, your energy, and your success. Now we want to talk about maybe some specific things that you need to do in order to be a good teammate. We at my school that I coach at and what I've gone through, I actually started with a thought process from Alexander Hamilton. Some of you guys know Alexander Hamilton. He has this play that's out. It's not his play, but it's about Hamilton is the play that's about him. He's on our $10 bill. And Alexander Hamilton once said that, stand for something or you'll fall for anything. And that kind of makes me think about, how do we gauge what we stand for? What are the values that you hold dear? And what are the values that make us great teammates, great coaches, great teammates, great people, great coworkers? What are those values? And I started to think about it. And when I first started coaching, I came up with some things that I called the commitment list. And it basically says, I will not do this. I will not drink. I will not cuss. I will not gossip. I will not do this. And it just became a rule list. And for me, when I saw that, I thought it was a great thing because these are the things I didn't want my players doing. And every once in a while or every year or two, I'd add some more things. This is something else I don't want you to do. This is something else I don't want you to do. And many times my players came to me and my players were like, well, coach, what are we supposed to do? And some of my players, even to this day, will be like, oh, Coach T, you're breaking rule 173, paragraph 2, line C, addendum 4. And they have a really good time. They laugh about it a lot. But for me, that big question is, what are we supposed to do? Kind of hit me pretty hard. And I thought to myself, I said, you know, I think that instead of telling people what they shouldn't do, I want to develop a culture of what we should do. A value system that makes us who we are. And so as we developed culture and we decided to be, okay, what is a good teammate? We came up with these 7 things. We're going to break these 7 things down a little bit, but I've actually included them. It's actually our Belhaven University, Belhaven Volleyball family values. Again, I had a sophomore or a junior at the time come up to me and say, hey, coach, what are we supposed to be doing? And she asked us if we could revisit some of our commitment list and take the negativity out of it that said, don't do this, I won't do this, I won't do that. And we started saying, I will. And so we sat down with a freshman, with a sophomore, with a junior, with a senior, my assistant, Laura Grace, and I, and we all 6 of us sat down and we decided to come up with our family values. What do we stand for? And again, we need to find something you stand for. And I'm just going to give you the things that I believe make you a better teammate. And I have them written down here. You can follow along. I went ahead and put the attachment within this unit. So if you need to pause it and print out that attachment, you can read along with us. Or you can just look down there and you can find find each step with us. But we're going to break these down a little bit to talk about our family values and our values that we stand for as a program. When I'm asking you to be a great teammate, I believe you need to stand for these as well. So let's go ahead and take a look at the first one. The first one says, we make wise decisions. And I'm going to go ahead and change the we to a good teammate will make wise decisions. And in our thing, it says that I'm an adult. Many of you that are watching this are not 18 years old yet, and that's all right. But you have to understand that you are a person that it has high character. You are a leader. If you play a sport, you have all these academic things that are tugging on you. You have all these things that are asking for your time, and you're also practicing 2 to 3 to 4 to 5 nights a week. You're going to weights, you're training, you're doing all these things that you have to do. And so when I say that I'm an adult and I talk about it here, you might not be an adult as in terms of 18 years or older, but you have all these responsibilities. So you are a mature person. And I will act like a mature person. I realize my actions reflect not only myself, but my volleyball family as well. I will try to decide if the decision I'm about to make is a wise decision when it comes to the consequences, whether known or unknown by my team. And this is kind of, I think that showing you that a good teammate makes wise decisions, I think that kind of is a big, huge umbrella to tell you a lot of different things. That can go across the board. But one of the things I want to try to think about, I want you to think about is, most people know your team by the individuals that are on your team. Very often when you watch the news will say something like, Alabama football player arrested, or Bellhaven volleyball player achieves greatness. That's what I like to say there. But, you know, they don't necessarily say Susie was arrested, or Susie did something wrong, or Susie went to help out at a group home, or Susie helped feed the homeless. They usually say Bellhaven volleyball player did this. Ole Miss football player did this. Florida basketball player did this. They represent a lot of times on the news, and even I get emails that don't say, you know, Susie was on her phone during class today. The emails that I get say things like Bellhaven volleyball player or volleyball player on their phone in class. And so when I talk to you about making wise decisions as a great teammate, those are things that I'm talking about, because now that professor, that teammate, the people that are watching the news, whatever it may be, all those people or that person, they now don't just associate it with Susie, they associate it with the whole team. So as we make wise decisions, the decisions you're about to make, maybe you're going to a party, maybe you're about to yell at your mom in front of everybody at a club tournament. The people on the other side, they're gonna be like, oh, I remember that club, that one player, but that club always yells at their parents. That club always yells at the line judges. You can show that to your mom. That club always yells at the scoreboard operator. The decisions that we make aren't just for ourselves anymore. When we say that we are part of a team, our decisions represent our whole team. So when I say the decisions you're about to make, think about the decision you're about to make and say, is this a wise decision when it comes to the consequences that are going to come from my decision? These consequences are going to affect my whole team. Again, it's not just me right now making this decision. I am a part of blank volleyball, whatever volleyball team you might be a part of. For me, I'm a part of Bellhaven volleyball. And if somebody sees the decision I'm about to make and they say, Bellhaven volleyball player does this, is it going to reflect us in a positive light or in a negative light? And that's when I say we make wise decisions. A great teammate makes wise decisions in everything that you do. So number one, in order to be a great teammate, you need to make wise decisions. Now let me take a look at number two here. A great teammate takes personal responsibility. I'm going to say that again because it's such a huge, huge statement. A great teammate takes personal responsibility. I am not perfect. I make mistakes. But when I make a mistake, I will not blame anyone else for my mistake. I am responsible for my own actions. I am responsible for my diet. I might have to skip that one and I'll cut it out later. I am responsible for my effort. We talked about it before. And I am responsible for my academics. Too many times I look around and I find other people saying that they're responsible. I go to these national qualifiers. I go to these club tournaments and I watch hitting lines. And all of you have seen it before. I feel so bad for setters. Because every time during the hitting line, they set the outside, and the outside's like, take it up a little bit. No, bring it down some. Bring it out. Oh, pull me off. What kind of set was that? Or middles won't even swing at a ball. And it's they're saying, you need to change your set. And I can promise you, whatever set they give you, you better feel excited about it. Because if you're not excited about it, you complain too much, you ain't getting set again. You need to take personal responsibility. And whatever set's there, you need to put it in. You don't say it's a bad set, that's why I hit it out. No, they set you, okay? That's already done. Don't blame anybody else for your failures. It's the same thing that happens in life. one of the biggest times that I ever got upset in a practice, I was talking to a setter and I asked the setter, I said, can you set the ones a little bit closer to you? And the first words out of her mouth, well, the middles aren't coming close to me, coach. And that was the way that she reacted to me. And I was like, well, I won't tell you exactly what I said. I didn't cuss, but I got pretty close to it because it was so upsetting for me. The first words out of her mouth is blaming somebody else. When I'm asking her to do something to change her setting, the first words out of her mouth was blaming somebody else. So for me, when I say a great teammate, and I'm asking you to be a great teammate takes personal responsibility. There's a book that's called Extreme Ownership. I would encourage everybody to watch it. I know some of the college players that I know that are going to other programs, their coaches make them read it. Way to go, coaches. But what I want you to think about is I want you to take ownership. I want you to take ownership with everything that happens on the court. I want you to take ownership with everything that happens in the classroom. I don't want you to say, well, it wasn't on the study guide. Well, boo-hoo. All right? When you're in a class, you study what's in the book. If it's in the book, it's in the lectures, it's going to be on the test. Don't just study the study guide. Study the subject. Take personal responsibility and don't blame your professor. Don't blame your teacher. Don't blame the kid next to you. Well, the kid next to me didn't bring me a pencil for class. The teacher didn't have a pencil sharpener or one of these things. I was so dehydrated, my mom didn't refill my drink. You ever seen this on the sideline? Hey, mom, get me a drink. Even though you sat for the last 2 hours on Snapchat when you could have got your own water bottle filled up. But we'll go into that in another session. But take personal responsibility. It says, I take personal responsibility for my own actions. I take personal responsibility for my own diet. Don't blame your coach because you're tired or you're not fit or you're not ready to play a 5-set match or a 3-set match or play all the way through on a qualifier third day and you're going for a bid and you're so out of shape. That's not your coach's responsibility. It's not your coach's responsibility to make sure that you didn't eat Chick-fil-A and 25 fried chicken tenders at Cane's during lunch. It's your responsibility to do those things. I'm responsible for my effort. Don't say, well, the set wasn't there or she's not giving effort. I don't care about her. I care about you. You have control of you. So give great effort. It's your responsibility to give great effort. You can't blame anybody else. You have an opportunity. I already spent 20 minutes on it, so I'm not going to spend any more time, but you have responsibility for your own effort. And then lastly, I'm responsible for my own academics. We briefly touched on it before, but remember, in order for you to play college volleyball, you have got to pass high school. It's a concept you might not understand. In order for you to play college volleyball, you also have to go to class in college. You also have to take those things seriously. You have to make the grade before you can make the play. I say it all the time to our players. You have to take care of your academics. Take personal responsibility for what happens in your life. Your attitude in life is 10% what happens to you and 90% the way you react to it. But you have 100% responsibility for everything that happens in your life. You can change and you can start today. Take personal responsibility. Number three, this is a huge one that I've never used before we started this. This is something that I think is so huge to be a great teammate. And I'll be honest with you, I just talked to somebody on the phone, one of my recruits. She asked me, Coach, how did I do in this qualifier I was just at this morning in Atlanta, Big South? And I said, the one thing that you need to improve the most has nothing about technique in volleyball, nothing about your setting or your attacking or your defense or your serving, or your blocking or anything like that. The one thing that you can get better on is number three. And it's listed right down here. A great teammate will hold their other teammates accountable. It is your responsibility. Ultimately, it's my responsibility as a head coach. But if we're developing this culture, I need other people that are on the court that can hear what's said in the huddle, that can hear what's said underneath their breath, can see what they're doing on Friday night and on Saturday morning when they're eating tons and tons of ice cream right before we play. We need to hold each other accountable. Let me read through this. When I make a poor decision, it is my teammate's right, and think about this, my teammate's responsibility to call me out. It is my responsibility to listen to constructive criticism. Let me make sure you see that too, that word constructive. We're going to go over in just a second, but I want to listen to constructive criticism, not destructive criticism, but constructive criticism. There are so many times in your life that you're going to be destructed by a coach, by a mom or dad sitting in the stands, maybe somebody across the net, by maybe your own teammate. Listen to constructive things that say, what I need you to do is make your platform here instead of here. Those are constructive things. Those are things that can say, don't listen to somebody that says, you stink, you can't hit the ball in, just serve the ball in. That's not constructive criticism. That's destructive criticism. We'll talk about it in a second. It is my responsibility to listen to constructive criticism and change to better the family. It is also my responsibility to help others who may be making poor decisions to change their actions for the sake and betterment of our team. Let me talk to you a little bit about this. This is huge. All three of these so far are huge. We talk about making wise decisions. That's a huge umbrella. Taking a personal responsibility. If you take personal responsibility and the first words out of your mouth every single time is, yes, sir, yes, ma'am, no, sir, no, ma'am, I'm sorry, coach. Those words will set you apart in a college, in any coach's view. If you take personal responsibility in life, you are going to set yourself apart. But also, I'm looking for that next level teammate. I'm looking for that teammate that sees somebody not giving great effort and say, hey, Susie, I know you are better than this. I need you to give me better than this. Hey, Tammy, I know you're going through some stuff right now. I really do. I understand that. But we can't do anything about it now while we're in this gym. What we can do about it now in this gym is get better in volleyball. And the way we get better is you giving better effort. I need you to swing. I need you to listen to coach. I need you to stop blaming your setters. And I need you to do your job. And when we hold each other accountable, that girl's going to say, you know what? You're right. Thank you. And it helps them to refocus their whole mindset on getting better. And guess what? When they get better, you get better. Not only you, but your whole team gets better. So a great teammate holds their teammates accountable. Now, let me come back to this. It is my responsibility to listen to constructive criticism. All right, I'm going to step on some toes right here, and you can play this for your coaches. I just spent a whole lot of time in Atlanta this past weekend watching Big South. I saw coaches be destructive to their team. I also saw teammates be destructive to their team. When I ask you to listen to constructive criticism and I ask you to give constructive criticism, you always need to know these two words, and it's listed right there where it says the Volley Academy. You always need to add value to your teammate. Now, I'm not telling you to pat them on the back and say, oh, you're okay, Susie. You're doing great. Just get your elbow up. That's not what I'm asking you to do. I'm asking you to make them better. And when I say make them better, always don't look at the skill. Encourage the athlete and dissect the skill. Got it? Encourage the athlete means don't sit there and yell, just get the ball in. Say, hey, let's serve one really aggressively. Or hey, let's get that ball to the libero to her right side, but just make sure you get that ball right in front of her. Just serve the six. We got this. Trust your defense. There's a huge thing in terms of being constructive and being destructive with your criticism. We talk about positive sandwiches before, where we say, hey, you're doing a great job hitting. I need you to work on your blocking. Make sure your blocking's up here. Hey, your serving was absolutely awesome today. That's a positive sandwich. If you want to be that, you know, wonderful and rainbows and everything like that, great. That's wonderful. What I'm asking you to do, though, is I'm asking you to take the step to make your teammates accountable. You know they're talking about coach. You know they're walking around and going, oh my goodness, I'm never getting set. She never sets me. Oh, man. Coach always says, she won't even let me play. You're sitting out at the end of the bench, and you got the droops. You got to say, oh, I hit 15 balls out. The coach never gives me a chance. When you're sitting on the end of the bench right next to that girl and you're about to go in, say, get your butt up, get your chin up, and cheer for your teammates. You'll get another shot, and when you get a shot, do your job. There's so many times that our teammates need not necessarily a kick in the butt, but a push. And when I talk to you about pushing, I always tell people, I'm not pushing you back. I'm getting behind you and I'm pushing you forward. If I'm giving you a push, if I'm holding you accountable, consider it pure joy because I'm trying to make you better. And as a teammate, I'm asking for five of you to work on that one girl. So it's not just me talking to that one girl where she says, coach hates me, coach hates me, coach hates me. And they says, you know what? I need to make a decision and I need to change. I need to change to make my team better. And when she makes her team better, she's going to make you better. And that's what I'm asking you to do. So the three things we're talking about in this chapter four is a great teammate makes wise decisions. All that encompasses the big umbrella that talks about. A great teammate takes personal responsibility. We're not always yelling at you, but whenever we say something, there's a little bit of truth in every lie. So listen, hear it, and take responsibility for your failures. Don't blame anybody else that you hit the ball out. You hit it, okay? Don't blame anybody else for your failures. Take responsibility, learn from them, put them as stepping stones, and let's get the next one. And then the third thing that says a great teammate holds their other teammates accountable. That is huge. If you do those three things, just those three things, we have four more in the next section. But if you do those three things, you're going to be a great teammate. We'll be right back with chapter five.